statement's theme is bringing ZANU-PF and Zimbabwe back to constitutionalism. We, the veterans of the National Liberation War, would like to state as follows. We applaud the gallant role taken by the Zimbabwe Defense Forces in defense of Zimbabwe's constitution to normalize the situation within the ruling ZANU-PF. That ZANU-PF returns quickly to constitutionalism and sets aside all the dismissals that were instigated by Kasukuere on all progressive people, especially this purging was focusing mostly on people with a liberation history. Therefore, we are saying that all people that were expelled or suspended because of the G40 cabal from the Central Committee, provinces, districts, and some ordinary members, which were dealt with unprocedurally by the so-called National Disciplinary Committee, this should be reversed by the Central Committee of ZANU-PF as it stood after a day after the December 2014 Congress. We urge that as the Central Committee reconvenes, it should quickly embrace and institutionalize the idea of the War Veterans League as a fourth wing of the Revolutionary Party. The vanguard role of the war veterans, war collaborators, detainees should be reinstated and upheld. For you to for me to tell you that even before that is done, we sit here as the Dare Rechimurenga. The Central Committee should immediately establish a commission of inquiry into Robert Gabriel Mugabe, especially during the time he was in the leadership position of the party. Why he decided to join and work with anti-revolutionary elements of this country.
Yes.
Why he has chosen either to expel or to ignore those that defended him, fought and defended him during the war and even after the war. Why he decided with his wife to denigrate the Zimbabwe Defense Forces and the war veterans, war collaborators and detainees. Why he chose to have friends only associated with the Rhodesia regime. Why he chose to associate even with Jonathan Moyo. Very well, that Jonathan is a CIA agent.
Yes.
Why he chose to ignore Vice President Mnangagwa's report in response to what Jonathan has alleged to him.
Yes.
We urge that Robert Gabriel Mugabe should be recalled from his role as the President and First Secretary of ZANU-PF. Yeah. This is not the first time that we are doing this. We did this to Ndabaningi Stole, who had lesser crimes. We want to make it very clear that offenses that have been committed by Robert Gabriel Mugabe are much worse than those alleged to have been committed by Gawaningi's colleague. We urge all people within the party, especially the youths and women, Women's League, to support this great initiative to return the party to constitutionalism. Yes. 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 How do we have a political party that is fronted by wings instead of the main wing? Yeah. Yes. The Women's League becomes bigger than the main wing. The Youth League becomes both the leading arm and also the army. Because if Tichipanga can threaten the Zimbabwe Defense Forces with the war, then he is not a leader of the youths, he is a commander of an army that we do not know. For that, he must be brought to book. Yes. But what worries us is why the president allowed a person to have a quasi-military in a state that has got an army. Because by not reprimanding Kudzi, he agreed that Kudzi, in fact, leads an army. We urge all political parties in Zimbabwe to support a return to normalcy in the country to avoid any violent inclinations. The Zimbabwe National Liberation War Veterans Association recognizes that all the political parties in Zimbabwe recognize and respect, uphold the role that was played by war veterans, war collaborators, and war detainees. And therefore, we do not have a reason to have them as enemies. So when we say we want to have normalcy in the running of this country, we also want to facilitate good and proper running of political parties in the forthcoming elections. So the army is there to restore order and sanity. And like I've said, this has been long overdue. And we support that